they been like that?
Just get me to Weaver, Sheriff.
You're taking a big chance on a local crazy lady now. I hope you're right about her, or we can kiss this town goodbye.
I mean, she knows the history. She was around that time.
I hope you know how to deal with this, Wake. I guess you New Yorkers are used to rough situations like this.
Right. The city's a war zone. King Kong, mutant alligators, and Alex Casey shoots the place up every weekend. Look, I never even carried a gun until a couple of days ago.
Well, my dad used to be a cop there. Tell some pretty wild stories.
Stuff like this?
No, just normal bad stuff. Kinda like your books, Wake. I used to tease Dad that he was just like Alex Casey.
You've read me.
Oh, sure. You're a pretty good writer. A little heavy on the metaphors, maybe.
Nobody's ever said that before.
We're coming up on the power plant. See the lit building over there? And that's the dam further up the river. I can't land here. I'll take her down the road across the river.
Just get me there, Sheriff.
What happened to my... It's like every cutscene, I always lose my weapons and my flashlight. I don't get it. What is that?
I had to do something about the chain for the door to open.
I'm already on it, Alan. I already got what I need. The darkness blurs her face. The darkness controls the taken. You know that. Oh my God! Stop! Look at my face! Back your ass! Get in the light. Fuck. Maybe all of this. Yep. that too.
Here's a new song from a band that they always remind me of our local rock legends, the Old Gods. I couldn't tell you why. I guess it's just, one of those things. Anyway, here's Poets of the Fall and their latest single, War.
Come on! No, get in front of me. Get in front of me. Y'all bugging right now. I'm over here. Fighting for my life. I got a theme song going on right now. It's probably gonna get copyrighted. Boy. Hey! Yo! They gave nothing to me, gang! Oh! God! Y'all is not playing fair at all.
And here's a new song from a band that they always remind me of our local rock. Anyway, here's come on, man, y'all got me cornered over here. Yeah.
Come on. Y'all is whooping my ass. Y'all coming down at me this hard? Apparently y'all don't want me somewhere y'all don't want to be at. No, I don't want to be at. Y'all are destined. Definitely what I needed, a flashbang. These dudes was not playing with me. Oh, God damn it. Why did I waste that? I need that. Stay in front of me. I don't know if we got electrocuted, huh? Hey! Manuscript. Ah, damn, I missed a lot of pages. I mean, I've been attacked a lot. In there. I gotta go over there. crane to get up there. Okay. Gotta be careful now. Also, y'all surrounded me, huh? I like it. Take care of yourself. There's a bridge over there. My checkpoint going in. Goddamn crows. Okay, I gotta turn it. Oh my God! You better not play with me. Quit playing with me. Tough as it is.
Abstract. And yet, so is it.
Oh, snap. It's Sarah and Barry. Let's go.
We managed to lose the flock. You're almost at the power plant. Keep going. We'll give you some more.
I need that light. Definitely the support I need. Get through it. Hey! Feel me? Again.
The logo on the power plant sign. I'd seen a version of it painted all over the area, signifying hidden caches of supplies.
Huh. Safe haven?
Miss Weaver! Cynthia! I'm a friend!
Prove it!
You knew Zane! Thomas Zane! You're the Lady of the Light in the song! You can help me!
About time! Young man, I've been waiting a very long time for you.
It's in the well-lit room.
Excuse me?
What you'll need to drive the darkness back. Well-lit room is at the dam. I built the room to keep it safe.
Will it help me find Alice? Will it get me back to the cabin? Fine, let's go. I can get my friends to come back with the helicopter.
She was well equipped.
We won't go outside. Never at night. That's rule number one. You've been breaking rules, young man, and where has that gotten us, hmm? Oh, I have a secret route, a lit route, an old water pipe. So something was damaged at the transformer yard. It may no longer reserve power. Without it, the pipe will go dark. The power to the yard must be cut.
Let me guess. You want me to do it?
Young man, you're the one who likes to break the rules. I can't be outside in the dark. The kill switch is outside.
I mean, I commend her for being safe in the power plant.
I have been preparing for these times, the dark tides. You have found my ashes, haven't you? You can see the signs. Very few people can. Yes, please, take what you need. This is all for you, for the likes of us. We do Tom's work, don't we? Hurry! The switch is on the wall facing the shore.
Jesus. You feel me? Goddamn.
Weaver had sent me to cut the power to the transformer yard. I was willing to do grunt work for her to get her to help me. I hoped Weaver was dependable. I'd stumbled into this crazy world a little over a week ago. She had been living this insanity for decades.
Rule number two, never go out at night. You said that the first time.
I could see the kill switch that would cut the power to the transformer yard. Now I had to find a way to reach it.
Rule number three. Two, keep the light on.
Yep,
that's what I'm doing. Make it back. Fuck yeah. Where is he? I hear you, but I don't see.
Started writing and woke the darkness up. He tried to bring them back, but you can't do that. There are no free rides like that.
I'm starting to realize that.
In that case, young man, perhaps you're a smarter man than Tom was. The witch looked like her, but it wasn't. Barbara was sweet. He didn't understand until it was too late. He tried to undo it, wrote himself, her, everything he'd ever written out of the world. Oh, he was so famous. And afterward, no one knew. He left only one thing behind him, my dear, in case it happened again. Insurance. He trusted me. Or perhaps used me a little. Tom knew how I felt. Knew I wouldn't refuse him. I built the well-lit room and it's been waiting for you. We are characters trapped in a story. And none of us will survive to see the end. If the darkness isn't stopped, she'll twist the story to her own dark ends.
How do you know all this?
Tom, that's the way he wrote it. He still talks to me, you know, in television, from beyond, from below. We've both been touched by the darkness, young man. He saved us both with light. The darkness stays with you. You sustain.
Okay.
This pipe will take us directly to the well-lit room.
Okay, I need to call my friends, tell them where we're going.
Hello? Ow!
Barry, we're headed to the dam in one of the pipes. Meet us there.
Okay, I'll tell Sarah.
Is Sarah now? Barry! Barry! We gotta go see if they're okay.
They're probably dead. You must reach the well-lit room. This is no time to be a selfish idiot.
That's my best friend!
Well, be a fool. I'll use the pipe. I'll meet you at the dam if you make it.
Come on, Alan.
At least I didn't have to worry about her. She knew how to stay safe.
A well-lit room. Okay. Okay, there it is. I'm like...
For it to be free, the Dark Presence needed the writer to finish the story. Again and again, the story let it get frustrated. Alice had screamed until she had no voice left to scream. Around her, the darkness was alive. It was cold and wet and malevolent and without end. She was a prisoner, trapped in the dark place. The terror would have burned her mind out, but one thing made her hang on. She could sense Alan in the dark. She could hear him. She could see the words he was writing as flickering shadows. He sensed her too. He was trying to work his way to her.
Okay. So, she's still...
The story I had written in the cabin had come true. Touched by the dark presence, I had written a horror story. But the end was still missing. The story was incomplete, and the last unfinished page of the manuscript still sat in the typewriter in the cabin study. If I could get back there, if I could read the page, then I could write my own ending to this story and save Alice. Sarah was almost starting to relax. Maybe they could turn this into a win yet. Suddenly, there was a piercing sound, like a table saw gone wild, as 100 birds made out of shadows swarmed into the rotor. The chopper bucked wildly and the board lit up, telling her what she already knew. They were going down. Barry Wheeler screamed next to her.
That crash site, boy.
Oh.
circles. Yeah, dude.
As far as I could tell, the wreck was empty.
Let me drop some flares. The well lit one. Nothing important. Let me look in here. Let's go, team.
Impossible!
Ah! Ah! Do something!
Oh.
Bet.
Was that it?
So much better to have a team on your back.
Wow, I think we're okay.
The taking is filled with darkness, you know.
Wake, call the elevator. I'm keeping watch.
I hear something moving around.
We're almost there. There's an entrance into the dam at the top. What's the plan, Wake?
Well, Weaver's crazy, but she's got something Zane left behind. Something to fix this.
Gee, could you be a little more vague?
Thomas? Zane? Seriously? Might as well be Paul Bunyan or Bigfoot.
Yeah, well, he was real.
I mean, the stuff that's going on right now, you better believe Thomas Wayne. Thomas Zane.
Oh, jeez, I hate this.
Okay, wait. There's a button over there that opens the door. I think something's broken. Hold the button down so we can get in.
Fucking me up. it and went down. Using the A and the B button. So be right.
During the Second World War, they operated here back then. They must have built this.
Yes, they did. It's my place now. Need changing soon, and I don't want to climb up the ladder to change them because it's very late and I'm tired. And if you take it, I won't have to do that anymore.
The page was autobiographical, a memory from my childhood. But I didn't write this. It was a page written by Thomas Zane. None of them were supposed to exist anymore.
Alan, 7 years old, would fight sleep to the bitter end. When he did sleep, he soon woke up, screaming, the nightmares fresh in his mind. One evening, his mother, sitting by his bed, offered him an old light switch. She called it the clicker, and flicking the switch would turn on a magical light that would drive the beast away. To imbue the talisman with all possible power, she added that it had been given to her by Alan's father. Alan never knew him, and anything of his took on mythical proportions in his mind. With the clicker firmly in his hand, Alan finally slept like a baby. Now, almost 30 years later, Alan thought of this as he stood on the rim of Cauldron Lake, the clicker in his hand. He took a deep breath and jumped.
My mind swirled. I'd given the clicker to Alice, yet it was here. Zane had written it into existence in a story I had written. I can get to her now. I can finish this.
All right, y'all. That's the end of, what was it, chapter 5? What was it? What was it called? I forgot what it was called. But anyway. Oh, man. So many things unpacked about this chapter. First off, you end up finding, I keep forgetting her name. Was that Cynthia Weaver? Yeah, Cynthia Weaver. She lived in the power plant surrounded with light. Like she understood. She knew Thomas Zane and Barbara Jagger. And she knew about the darkness. And she was the one that was pinging around the town with the with rules what you need to do when it comes to the darkness. And we ended up going up there. We ended up having a hassle with the darkness and with it taken. And we finally understand what was the importance of the clicker. And our theory was correct that Alice is still alive out here. So the order to finish the darkness, we need to get back to the cabin, which apparently it disappeared on the first episode because she was trying to hit it from Alan so he won't finish the story and Alice. So man, this is getting good. I don't know, this probably might be the last episode. But if you enjoy this gameplay, put a thumbs up, subscribe if you're new, comment down below what you think about this chapter. I'm gonna end it right here, man. Peace.